you. After what you did, man, what you expected? You motherfucker, you motherfucking right. You motherfucking right, I'm bitter. You motherfucking right, I'm triggered. You motherfucking right,
what's up, YouTube? So today I'm gonna be doing a advice video, tips if you're going to middle school, okay y'all? It's like all that good stuff. So let me tell y'all something right now. If you go to middle school, it's nothing like elementary, pre-K, kindergarten. Your friend you had in kindergarten that was always nice to you, no. The middle school, when you go to middle school, it's like everything changed, like everything upside down. You're so judgmental at middle school, okay? Anything you do that's wrong, they're gonna judge you, they're gonna talk about you. If you smell, they're gonna talk about you. They're gonna post you on the Snapchat, they're gonna post you on Instagram. Then she stank, this and that. So here are some tips to help you not to be on the Instagram being talked about, the Snapchat, whatever. Tip number one, always wear deodorant. If you do not wear deodorant, somebody gonna say, somebody musty. They're directly talking about you. But they're not gonna say your name, they're gonna say somebody musty. Then one person go around smelling everybody's arm, and then they're gonna do the face on your arm, and then everybody gonna laugh and talk about you, and you're gonna feel embarrassed, you're gonna wanna go to the bathroom, you're gonna cry, da 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 da. Wear deodorant. I promise you, it will save your life. Wear deodorant. Tip number two. Don't be the teacher's class pet. Because I'm telling you, that class, don't be the class pet. The class, your classmates will be so jealous of you. Oh, she get this. Oh, she get that. You always let her do what she want. Bada, bada, bada. And he's going to talk about you. He's going to call you a snitch. You all, don't be the teacher's class pet. Don't get too close to him. Hello, goodbye. That's not your friend, okay? Don't be the teacher's class pet. Because you will get talked about. Tip number three. Alright, tip number three. This is like one of my serious things. Never, ever, ever. This is for girls. For girls. Never, ever. If you know you're on your period, don't come to school. I'm not saying don't come to school, but come to school with pads. If you don't come to school with pads, there's gonna be blood. Y'all know what I'm trying to say. Wear your pads. Cause let me tell you, if they see blood on the back of your pants, oh no. It's over for you. You're not gonna come back to school anymore. Wear your pads. Make sure you clean back up. Cause if they see that blood, it's over for you. All the way to high school, it's over for you. Tip number four. Let me tell y'all, never ever start beef at school. Cause then there's these friends that's gonna tell you to stop, and there's these friends who wanna encourage it on. And you will have fake friends, okay? Never start beef. Cause some people gonna be like, coming to you, telling you to talk about the person you want to fight, and then they could be going back to the other person saying this and that, yada yada yada. Never get into a fight. Try to stay far away from that as you can. Tip number five. I promise y'all, there's gonna be this one or two friends that will mess over you. They'll talk to you because it's your first year, you've never been to this school, yada yada yada, you never met these people before. And they'll get you into trouble. Trust me, it happened to me. They will get you into trouble. Never. Why should you be friends with people who tell you to do stuff? People who bring you into mess? That's not your friend. That is not your friend at all. Don't listen to them. Okay? Okay. So here's some advice. If you're just going to middle school, yeah, people will judge you on what you wear. So let me tell y'all some things that you should wear, but maybe if you can't afford it, this is what you should do. If your mom can't afford to get your hair done, braid it up. If you don't know how to braid, go watch some YouTube tutorials. Braid your hair. Put your hair in a ponytail. Do not go to school looking like who did it. Don't do it. don't go to school looking like who did it. Cause then they gonna talk about you. Talk. Talk about you, okay? Don't go to school looking like who did it. Please, I'm begging you. Cause you will have the same experience I did. And it is not a great experience and it's not fun. So, as I was saying, what you should wear, if you got a uniform, if you don't have a uniform, let's say whoever don't have a uniform. If your mom can't afford the stuff that you want, that you see everybody with, try to gather some of it, like every piece of like coin you get, put it in a jar. Save it up. For summer when you want to get new clothes, you're going to have money to get what you want. So don't, every time you get money, it don't have to be all your money you get, but at least a little coin you find around the house, put it in the jar. Glue the jar together, and then at the end of the year, break it up. Break the jar and get all the money out. If your parents could afford and you just don't know how to dress, I can help you. Can't help you. Just know how to dress, okay? So, if you wear a uniform and you get talked about because of your shoes, don't worry about that. It's just that people are so judgmental, and I don't want you to go through what I went through with my first year in middle school. Because, baby, it does not feel good. They will put you in group chats and rib you. It's just not a good feeling. So I'm telling y'all, keep yourself up in school. Make sure your teeth is brushed every day. Make sure you wear your deodorant. Make sure you brush your teeth. Make sure if you're on your period or your pads, be on it. Like, don't be so nasty. Don't take showers. Because there's this thing people do in middle school. They'll write on your arm. And then the next day, if you still have that mark on your arm, oh, they're going to expose you, baby girl. I'm going to tell you something. When you're starting middle school, do not be dirty. Do not be stank. Especially the girls out here. Some of you girls, I'm not saying all of everybody, don't take a shower next year's school. Take your shower. They will mess over you, okay, y'all? Like, y'all think I'm over-exaggerating, but take a shower. They will mess over you. Take a shower, please. And I'm saying this for your benefit. Put your deodorant on, okay? And if you play sports, and you're not good at sports, people are gonna dog you. I played volleyball for my school, Andrew Jackson Colonels. And I wasn't the best at volleyball. I really didn't get in the lot, so everybody would dog me. Oh, you a bitch woman, you never get in. If you're not that good, try out. Learn how to do it. Because you're going to get better. And when you do it again, you're going to prove to them that you got this. Okay? Do not let people in school bring you down. Especially these boys out here who think they could just bring you down, girl. No. You got it. Okay? So all my girls out here, if you're going to middle school, you're just starting, please take this advice. Put your deodorant on. That's like one of my biggest things. Because people be like, somebody must be. Even one day, I had forgot to put deodorant on because I wasn't at my house. And one of my teachers, she was like, somebody is musty. And then I knew it was me. And I just kept on doing this. And like somebody eventually came by me and smelled me and they made that fit. Whole class dogging me. Whole week dogging me. Okay? So ladies, at the end of the day, keep yourself up. Make yourself look like something. Don't go to school looking like who did it. Don't go to school smelling like a nasty diaper. Keep yourself up. Put your look. If you're wearing a skirt, don't be ashy. That's not cute. Put your lotion on. Make sure you got it together, because it took me a time to realize. My mom kept on telling me, you have to put your lotion on. You have to put your deodorant on. Y'all, let me tell you what my mama did. Every morning from sixth grade. Talia, you put your deodorant on? And it was so aggravating. Cause she kept on doing it. I'm like, Mom, yes, yes, I did, yes. Put your deodorant on. You don't have to go through that. And here's the thing about perfume. It's not mandatory. You don't have to put it on. But I advise you should put some on. Cause you be smelling like $1 million. Okay, girl? It could be from Family Dollar. You could get the best smelling one and still be smelling like $1 million. Add some perfume on to go to school. You smell good. You smell good. You smell good. And don't think your deodorant gonna save you from that must under your arm. I say your, that deodorant. Don't think that perfume gonna save you from that must under your arm. Don't be trying to spray under there. No. Get you some deodorant. Okay? Y'all, I'm really stressing about it. Like, y'all need to know the rules of middle school because they will dog you. They will talk about you and it's not a good feeling. So do this and you will be okay. Boys. The boys in middle school, they gonna talk about you because they like you. Talk about you because they like you. Put you in group chats and talk about you and rib you to everybody because, like, some people don't even like you. They just hate on you to see you hate. Like, let's say you got a brand new Gucci belt. You telling everybody your Gucci belt. Somebody just gonna be so jealous because they don't have that Gucci belt. They gonna go, oh, she ugly. Oh, that's fake. Oh, this and that. Oh, people is haters in middle school, y'all. And I promise y'all, y'all gonna realize if y'all don't take this advice, your middle school year is not gonna be great. Now I'm going on the 7th grade, my second year of middle school. Basically, I know this stuff that happened to me last year is not gonna happen to me this year because I've learned from my mistakes. And like when I didn't put that deodorant on, and I learned from my mistakes. When I didn't do my hair, I learned from the mistakes. So like now, I wouldn't say I'm an expert, but I realize what I should do this year to, you know, keep this year smooth. Like I said, don't get into any mess. If you get into a mess, there's not gonna be no way you're gonna drag yourself out of that. Okay? I don't care how much you say sorry. And if you say sorry, I don't wanna fight you. You scary. She fat. She fake. She lame. She da 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 da. She don't wanna fight. She don't want this smoke. I call her hands out. She ain't wanna do nothing. Post up. And you don't wanna post up because you know it just got into serious for no reason. Don't drag yourself into that mess. Don't do it. Don't do it. Because if you do, I cannot stress about this enough. You will not be able to get yourself out of that mess. So, like I said, put your deodorant on, spray some of that smell good on, wear your pad, do something with yourself. Wash your face in the morning. You don't want your face to be broken out. Wash your face. Make yourself look like something. Put your lotion on. If you don't put your lotion on, it's not gonna be cute. Carry your little purse. If you can't afford a purse, put some stuff in your book tag. If you forget to put some deodorant on and want to keep it in your little purse as a backup. Now, this is for all my plus size girls. Not plus size, you know, big girls. Like, I'm big. Y'all, they will dog you out on your weight, how fat you are. Just because you're heavy boned and you're thick. They will talk about you, how fat you are, you popping out the shoes, your skirt's so big, your stomach's so fat, you can't even sit down at the lunch table, you too fat, you about to break the whole bench. It will make you cry, it will drive you crazy. But you gotta know in your head that everything they're saying is just because they hate it. They're mad, they wanna be you, and it's just, you think that's hurting me? Tell them. You gotta tell them. You think that's hurting me? You gotta stay strong in your mind, in your head. Cause, I'm telling you, when they dog you, you're not gonna wanna go to school no more. You're not gonna wanna do nothing. You're gonna try your hardest to make yourself look like. I remember one day, I had got one of my mama, what's that called? It's something. I think it's called Sphinx. Keep your stomach in. And I was just so happy because like my stomach was flat the whole day and it was not popping on my shirt. But when I joined volleyball, I had lost a lot of weight. Okay? A lot. So like I'm saying, you should be active in school. You should do something in school because you lose weight, it's active. And like I said, if you're not good at what you do, practice, practice. When I joined volleyball and I realized I didn't know what I was doing, but I did make the team, I got a volleyball and I practiced. I set it, I bumped it all around the house. I even broke some. Keep on trying. Do your best. Put your deodorant on. Put your perfume on. Brush your teeth. Put your lotion on. I'm telling you, that'll be a big help in middle school. All you gotta do, you ain't gotta worry about nobody else talking about you, because you just ignore it. Keep yourself up. Stay to yourself. Mind your own business. Don't be a teeth class pet. You know, middle school is hard, and I promise y'all, I'm not even lying. It's hard. Don't be the girl that stinks. Don't be the girl who had never done. Don't be the girl who messy, who always talking about somebody, who always getting into fights. Mind your business. And everybody else, I'm not saying everybody's gonna mind theirs, but they gonna hate on you, and they gonna hate your hustle, and they gonna hate what you do. Don't worry about them. They out the window. Don't worry about them. Do you, boo? And that's all I have for you guys today. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe. Hit that bell for every time you know I drop a new video. And I'm out. Yeah. I'm addicted. And that's a whole lot of love. Ain't trying to waste it. Like we be running them out and never make it. That's just too bitter for words. Don't want to taste it. That's just too bitter for words. Don't want to taste it.